Hello again, everybody. Justin from iMicro Board Repairs, and today we have a Note 8, Galaxy Note 8, that was mailed in from Utah for data recovery. The gentleman was using the phone, watching a video, and shut off on him and never turned back on. So I've checked the board. I cannot find any clues. So rather than waste any more time, we want to get this done. We're going to transplant the chips from his board to a guaranteed working donor board and get this guy his data. So let's see how that goes. So here's our donor. I already have it prepared. Nice and squeaky clean. And then here's the customer's board. We are gonna take the CPU, as always, the CPU, the RAM, and the storage, which is the UFS, and we are going to populate them, transplant them onto our donor board. So let's do it. I got this board, it had already been worked on, so it's another reason I'm not going to spend any more time on it. We're just going to swap it. Let's cover our storage so we don't heat it unnecessarily while we're removing the CPU and the RAM. We got more glue on the edges, so you have to be careful. There's our RAM. Grab our UFS. Now let's remove all the glue. Second phone call. All right, back to business. Thank you. and I think we'll be fine. We don't need to remove all this glue. That's just for visuals. All right, let's do the CPU. Actually, let's do our RAM, and then we'll do our CPU. Thank you. clean. CPU. One second. Phone call. Okay, we're back. secure real quick. Reball our chips. Sorry about the noise coming from my hot air station. I think I need to put a new fan in it. I fixed it once, but it's gone back out, and I just haven't had the time to stop and fix it again. So my apologies. Well, my apologies for my audio overall. That'll be changing soon. I have very poor audio, so yeah, sorry about that. There's our CPU. Looking for my tweezers and they're right in front of my face. knew I shouldn't have used this stencil. I should have used my tried and true, but whatever. We're already halfway in this. Let's do this. Wow. Being a pain in the butt. Donor, finish this. Thank you. course, I'm sitting around all day. It's my day off. Nobody hits me up all day. I decided to come into the shop to get these two swaps done, because after this we'll be doing an S9. And everybody's texting me. Oh, I'll just get back to them when I'm done. UFS and watch it jump into place. Watch it dance. I'm gonna have to pause this. I don't know why, but people are not listening to me. I'll be right back. Okay, all the texting and phone calls are out of the way. Let's go ahead and test this thing now. Let's check our work real quick. It on. Okay, we got a logo. That's a good sign. Oh, someone was messing with it. Looks like it's in the middle of an update. Let's just wait for this. Android guy there. I don't like what I'm seeing here. Hope his other shop didn't ruin this guy's chance to get his data by not only working on the board but also doing software. Android guy says, please, please. Okay, let's see what happens. What's our fate? Way in case it turns on so you don't see anything that's personal. Just chilling on the ATT logo right now. Starting Android. Better not be a wiped phone. Wow, they erased his phone. And this is why you need to be careful who you send your jobs to for data recovery. Wow. Wow, just wow. The incompetence of some people is just mind-blowing. Mind-blowing. See, it says, an unauthorized attempt has been made to reset your device to factory default settings. Connect to Wi-Fi or mobile network to verify your identity. Wonderful. Alright, we're going to pause this, and I will be right back. Alright, so just got off the phone with the customer and he did take it to Geek Squad, and that's what happened to it. So that's a wrap. Thank you, whoever you are that screwed the chance of this guy, screwed the pooch of this guy getting his data. Insane. Be careful who you send your phone to for data recovery. That's all I gotta say. Catch you next time, guys.